Hi, Travis from POSGuys.com. This is part two of our wristband series. In the first video, we went over the basic wristbands available and the recommended printer for it. So in this second video, we're going to go into more of the setup and kind of how to get rolling with printing wristbands. Okay, what you'll need is your printer. This is the ZD410, which we recommended in the first video. It's just a basic label printer, but it's good for just a single attendance. You know, as people go through the door, you print five wristbands out, one wristband, whatever you need. Just kind of doing one-offs as needed. You'll also need a PC, Windows PC, and I'm running the free version of the ZebraDesigner. This is the one that comes with your printer. If you want to get the pro version, you get additional options and you can tie it into your database and do a lot more advanced tracking. But if you just want to print basic daily wristbands, this is kind of how it works. So the first step you need to do is to calibrate your printer. You load the media in like you would any other labels. It's drop-in loading, so you get it, you drop it in. The eye, make sure that the eye goes over the label. You'll see this little black mark on it. That's what it's looking for. So feed it in, close the lid, and if you hit feed, you should get a single label out of it. And you're going to stop right where it tears. If that doesn't happen, you need to calibrate. Calibrating is really simple. Hold down the two edge buttons for 2 seconds. When you let go, it'll slowly spit out one label. And then another if it's necessary. And there you go, you're calibrated after that point. So if it's stopping in the middle of the label, if you're seeing any kind of error lights, calibrate again. It's normally the issue and you just get away from there. After your printer is calibrated, you need to now set up your software. I'm gonna assume that you have installed the drivers for your printer and you're able to print from your PC to your label printer. If not, download the drivers at POSGuys.com. We'll also put a link down below in the description to the drivers. You're gonna wanna install it. Use the Zebra brand drivers. Do not use the Siegel Bartender drivers. If you're going to use the Siegel Bartender software, then you can use those drivers. But assuming that you're using the Zebra Designer software, then you're going to need the Zebra drivers, or else the software will not allow it to print to anything except the Zebra driver. So I'm going to switch over to the screen cap and we'll show you configuration of the printer. Here's my sample of the label. Right now I have it in a full print mode, which means that when you print it out, you're using the entire wristband. But if you actually look at a wristband, when you print and it wraps around your wrist, it doesn't use the entire wristband because some of the waist will be covered. So what we've kind of done testing some labels between different employees here is that you have between 4 and 5 inches of printing. Additionally, 1 inch of it, about that much, is not going to be printable because that's where your little sticky tab is. And so on either end, you're going to want to ignore 1 inch and we'll say 4 inches for this demo. So let's start a new label. First thing that's going to do is ask which printer. You're going to need to select your Zebra. If you have it installed any other name, it won't detect it. It's looking for a very specific printer, so make sure you select your Zebra printer. The stock type here, there's some preset labels, but I couldn't find the wristband in particular. So on it, I just left it as none, and I'm going to input the dimensions manually. So this asks if you want to set the page size. Leave it as automatic. You'll set the dimensions in a future setting. Portrait or landscape. For this, landscape is easier because it's going to make a little more sense. Portrait, if you get confused, switching to portrait mode sometimes can help orientate it because how it comes out of the printer is in a portrait mode. But I'm going to leave it in landscape so it's easier to kind of see. Okay, so this is where you're going to come into the width. So the trick to this whole thing is that the values need to add up to 10. Okay, so if you have no margin, so if you're going to print on 100% of the label, then set the label width to 10, the height is all the way 1, and leave the margins at 0. If you want to put in some padding, this is what you can do. So you can basically say, I want 6 inches of print area. On the left side, whereas the tab, I'm going to space off 1 inch. So that adds up 7. So on the right side, I'm going to have 3 inches of blank. Click off of it. So in this little preview screen, you'll see the white area is the usable area. So we're ignoring 1 inch, we're ignoring 3 inches. Click finish. So there's your label. You can zoom out if you need to. Right now it's zoomed into the printable area. If you zoom to page, then you'll see there's the area we ignore. There's the area you want. So from here, it's basically the same as setting up any other label. Now I'm going to start with the text. I'll put the name of the park. You know, I'm going to call it My Water Park. And say finish. You can increase the size by clicking the font button to make it bigger. You can change your font type into something a little more interesting. I'll just pick that. And you can move it around. You can bold it. You can italicize it. Whatnot. That is a fixed font. Every label that prints will do that. One other thing to do, which is very useful, is to print a date. So for that, we'll go to variable text. We'll click next. And on it, we'll click date field. Next. And it'll ask for the format. I'm just going with the standard format. And it'll ask if you want to do a prefix or a suffix. So this just kind of prints in addition to the date. So I'm just going to write date. And click finish. So there's the date on it. If you want to add a time, you do the same thing, but you just select time instead of date. Okay, and then the most important thing is the barcode. So this will be dependent on what kind of barcode reader you have. Barcode is assuming you're using a 1D barcode, so this can be read with any barcode reader. You're probably going to want to do variable barcode, and you're probably going to want to do at least a serial number. If you have the pro version of the software, then you can pull data out of that database. But you know, assuming you're doing some kind of serialization, you can just pick a counter, click next, starting value, I'll make it 1,000. You can also prompt before you want to print if you want to pull like a receipt number on it, but for ease of use, I'll just say 1,000. We'll increment each time. And this is the maximum number of digits. So that's what number you go up to before restarting. So click finish. All right. So we have a barcode here. So if it's red, that means it's off the label. So if you move it around, then it becomes black. You can stretch it out. So one thing to keep in mind is that when it prints, that it comes out of the printer in a portrait mode. So it's coming this way. So it's very difficult for a printer to print lines the opposite way, kind of going perpendicular with how this is laid out now. Or actually you want it to come out going perpendicular. Because the heat is coming in this direction, that it's much easier to print precise lines when this is rotated 180 degrees. So I'm just gonna click this rotation button so it flips it that way. And now that'll print nicely. If you print it the other way, it's just not gonna have sharp edges on the barcode and it might be difficult for your barcode reader to read. What's even better is to go with a 2D barcode. So I'll go with the QR code. 2D barcodes are just omnidirectional and they just print a lot nicer. We'll go with variable barcode again. And I'll go with the counter. Starting value is 1,000, 8 digits, finish. enlarge it. Put it at the edge. So 1D barcode, 2D barcode. I highly recommend going with the 2D barcode and a 2D barcode reader. It just will make it easier to put people through the lines, but if you have a 1D setup, then this will work as well. So that's your general layout here on the barcode, and we'll go ahead and do a test print. Okay, so it printed out of the printer, but it's kind of light. It's not super legible, but it worked as we intended. So the one edge is ignored, and then 4 inches ignored. So then when it's wrapped around the wrist, then it'll look like such. So in order to darken it up, it's a pretty easy setting. You just go in through your printer settings, and on it, they have your speed and your darkness. I'm just gonna crank this up by 10. Also, I'll take it to 25. Everything else stays the same in it. If you have any issues with the label looking funny when you print, you might need to specify the size of the label, and that is done right here. Your unprintable areas, you can leave blank, so don't worry about that. One other thing to check is under the advanced setup, you want it to be marked as mark sensing. It might, if it, by default, I think it comes as web sensing, where it's looking for gaps. That'll be a problem. It won't stop properly, so make sure you have it on mark setting. So I'm gonna hit OK, and I'm gonna print one more label. That's much better. So now it's dark, the barcodes are even easier to read, and there you go on it. One other thing that some people like to do is to put multiple barcodes all in a row. You can just copy and paste, copy and paste, copy and paste, and put them all the way down your label. That way you give yourself an even greater chance of reading your barcode on it. So that's up to you. I think it looks a little uglier, and if you have a good barcode scanner, reading the barcode normally isn't a problem, but that's totally up to you on how you wanna kinda do it. So that's kind of your basic setup for a wristband. On it, that you have some variable data. This increments on every print. If we check the settings on it, you can see how it's incrementing. And that's basically it. For more advanced settings, you'll need the advanced version of the software, and then you can tie into the database. For more information on the printer or to purchase, please visit us at POSGuys.com. Thanks.